Rage against the dying light. This is the illumANark reporting for the Explorers News Network. And we bring you Kyle Crane. Through our Nanite control, we control Kyle Crane in the city of Harran. This is where we have gained control of a GRE agent who is stuck between the decisions of corporate greed in the military industrial complex and doing the right thing by a people who are suffering. This is one of those moral dilemma games where you get to beat up zombies and pick apart moral dilemmas. Yes, it's Dying Light. That being said, we'll continue on with some of our coverage, and as we watch this Dying Light video, we will be able to sit back and realize a couple of interesting, lovely things about our world that we live in today. As I sit back and eat my Lay's potato chips, I realize they're barbecue flavor. And until recently, I had forgotten what my parents have always told me is, how do you make barbecue flavor for most of your processed foods? Well, it's formaldehyde. And this brings forth a random fact of the day. This random fact is about, well, our post-life experience, which seems so appropriate given the context of this particular game, Dying Light. Now, in 1950, there was a certain amount of materials used to embalm a body at the point of death. Okay. That was basically a sad but solid truth. There was only so much materials that were needed to maintain the human body so that it would be preserved for the early burial process, and rotting would not really ensue until sometime after the corpus was enshrined or otherwise put aside. So, that was 1950. And nowadays, thanks to our lovely diets, which include so many preservatives that, well, now they need to use 1/3 the amount. That is without a major increase in the quality, strength, or even usefulness of the materials to embalm the body. So, that being said, where do we stand? Well, we die 2/3 better preserved than we did 1950. The terrifying prospect of that is that our diet is filled with so many preservatives when you're looking at all the garbage we actually eat. So, that being said, it is on to the next point. And that point comes to the, I wanted to have a schedule in place. I wanted to produce videos every single day and have videos going out every single day. But, you know, there's a little problem I've had in recent days. I've had a defibrillator installed. That is basically, it's a pacemaker and defibrillator. It allows me to when my heart rate gets too high, too low, asynchronous, any of those above circumstances exist, and I get a thump to the chest, just like they were using the paddles on me in the hospital. So, I have to say, it's not the most pleasant truth, but it is a truth. So, I look forth from that point. But I ended up in the hospital twice in the last week. Now, this is actually not very often for me, well, it's often for recent days. But, I have not near... If you doubled the number of days I've actually spent in the hospital and ER, if you doubled the number I've already had this year and tacked that on for the number I had done for the rest of the year, I'd have still as little as 10% of the number of days I've had hospitalized 3 and 4 years ago. I attribute this to the woman that's in my life. The woman I love more than anything else. She has kept me running. She has given me strength. She empowers me in a way that is almost impossible to speak of. But these ER visits and the leap, boy, I have to admit, I'm fairly afraid of heights, and as a large man, that's kind of funny, because, I start out at a reasonable size, so, maybe a slightly above reasonable size, but I really have to say, my life has been very good. And I have to be very thankful for the woman that has made it possible for me to live the beautiful life I've been living for the last couple of years. And, though she does not want to be dragged out into the light, she's one of those people who's very much, I'd say more wallflower than anything else. Not comfortable with being in the spotlight whatsoever. Which is fine. That is the place in the world she was. I have to thank her for what she has done for me to improve my life. So that being said, on to our next point. We had some odd news yesterday. Odd news. Yes, not the even news, just the odd. The truth of this odd news was the fact that, there's a man in Argentina. San Paulo, I am not even going to try to pronounce it because I will just butcher it and leave a whole cross-section of people dissatisfied with the fact that I could not bring forth a good pronunciation of a city they either live in or live near. I don't wish to insult anyone, but fact is, I do not have an ability to roll that tongue in a way that is propagating words properly for Spanish, spoken Spanish whatsoever. So, I will deal with it and say that there was an article on Yahoo in their odd news section of a man who lived in Argentina, who has spent basically the last 40 years doing something a lot of people in America wish they could do. Unplugged, he was living off the grid. And that off the grid, let's just say he was living in a cave. But what surprised me was, you know, the comment section of Yahoo is so much more international than average kind of crowd. And that being said, you know, it puts a spin on how you get to see how other people view the world, view us in the world, view the things around us. And I'd have to say that for as much as that I know in the U.S., there is little, if any, acceptance of a particular state of one would call homelessness in the U.S. But it's houselessness. It's not necessarily homelessness. Home is where the heart is. But this man has, for 40 years, lived in a cave outside of the lovely city he grew up in. You know, and it got into how his life, he used to, you know, help bring coal to or across the border, because that was, well, what he was expected to do as a young man. But as he grew up, he took other career options. Those other career options included, well, hey, you know, living up on the mountain. In this comment section of Yahoo's news, very accepting overall. In fact, there was a lot of discussion about wanting to, being able to, or desiring to be off the grid, outside of the normal realms of control by the U.S. government. And I have to respect that, because I know what people lose when they lose everything. So, as we continue on with our news and continue on with our looking into things, I then came across an article that I wish I didn't even have to discuss. It was on Yahoo News, and it caught my attention. And I admit, it caught many a teacher's attention. Anyway. So we have here, what we have here is a failure to communicate. Yes, the people that I'm speaking of that were in the news, two separate occasions in the last couple of days, of people, women probably, who were highly overwhelmed by the one particular child's insistence on screaming, yelping, whatever it was they were doing that got the parents' attention. They wanted it to stop. They wanted it to stop at all costs. So fine, you know, that is what they wanted. What they got, far from it. That is okay. Because this is a world in which we can all work together. We can all build a world that's a better place. But don't leave your children in a locked car on a 90-plus degree day. How ever does that sound like a good idea? To slowly roast another human to death. Your own child, nonetheless. You crazy psycho. Just don't leave a child completely alone in a car that could reach upwards of 130 degrees while it's sunshine, buttercups, and all sorts of things outside. Take the child outside with you. Do you know they may have annoyed you? It's not worth trying to kill them, especially because you're more likely to be unsuccessful. People during this time of year are very vigilant about this exact subject. So why? Oh dear God, why would you do it? Because some people get aggravated. Some people get pushed too far. In the process, they cannot see the stupidity they're about to commit. They just get caught up in the fact that they need a break from a screaming child. And they don't say, hey, that break from a screaming child is gonna require me to, you know, put their life and possibly my life on the line. This is not acceptable. Ever. I don't know why you would consider it acceptable, but it seems that some people do. And I am trying to call out upon them and say, show some wisdom. Don't leave your child in the oven. Because that's what you're doing when you leave them in the car. Now, my children, let us discuss how I brought an end to World War III. Yes, I was able to bring an end to World War III. And you didn't even know it. Why? Because I am a traveler through time and space. I can see strange new vistas. I can visit times that have yet been not occurred, or have occurred in past, or may never occur, or will one day come to pass. I love being a time traveler. I love the fact that the woman I love is no one in the universe. She is no when. She doesn't exist. So, safety is she won't destroy history by traveling through it. Both being time travelers is of extreme importance. And I see this ticker is running up on 20 minutes. And I know it's running up on 20 minutes. But God only knows, for some reason, it is not going to let me know. I'm going to let me know when it has it the very end of it. I will keep talking bit by bit, just to have this track done. You gave my life to me, yes. Set me free. Anyway, it's a beautiful thing. I love this woman that is with me. I love that she understands the rigors of being a time traveler. And, well, she is there for me in a way that no one has been in my memory. And I do appreciate it. I appreciate it greatly. So I'm gonna see if I can bring justice to her path. And, well, keep bringing forth the light upon the mysteries of the universe. Well, we are coming up on the 21 and a half minute mark soon, and since I don't remember exactly how many minutes of footage I have, and I know that this will set the track in sync with the full length from tail end towards the beginning, and I don't want to cut out any video footage, but I know I will be at some point. So, with that, I say peace out. Peace out for today, peace out for tomorrow, peace out to you always. And I, the illumANark, am out of here. Keep it shiny. Oh, by the way, if you've made it to this point, feel free to put hashtag overcome in the comments below. Feel free to like, share, or even subscribe. Thank you very much, and have a beautifully shiny day.